Greetings of the day. In today's video of business finance, we will start with the numerical portion of working capital management. Till now, we have completed the theoretical aspect of working capital management. In this lecture, we will start with the numerical aspect, or we will start with the practical questions of working capital management. The question which we are going to take in this particular video is attached in the link provided with the video. Kindly refer to it for the question and we will discuss solution today. The question says that the company has an annual sales of 85 lakhs with profit margin of 25% on its cost, whereas the conditions of supplier, debtor and other things are provided in the question. We are being asked to prepare the working capital requirement statement so that we can ascertain the working capital of the company. So we will start with the solution. Before getting to the statement of working capital, as we have been given sales which includes profit element also, we would first of all deduct the profit element from it so that we could reach to the cost of sales, which can be used as a platform for the purpose of the calculation of various aspects of working capital requirement. So we will prepare first of all working notes. So working note would be for the calculation of cost of sales. Our annual sales given in the question is of 85 lakhs. We would deduct profit which is provided at the rate 25% on cost. So we would put the formula of 85 lakh into 25% divided by 100 plus 25. So it would be 85 lakh into 25 divided by 125, and we would get our answer as 17 lakh, which would be the portion of the profit. By deducting 17 lakh from 85,000, we would receive the amount of 68 lakh, which would be cost of sales that can be used for the purpose of various calculation in the working capital statement. So we can now start with the working capital statement. The formula which we have discussed for the purpose of working capital calculation was, we have said that working capital is equals to current assets minus current liabilities. Current assets minus its current liabilities. In the sheet provided, the pro forma of working capital statement is given. You should overlook it. If you have certain concern regarding to it, we will directly jump to the solution. So what we have to do, we have to deduct current assets. We have to deduct current liabilities from our current assets. So we will start with our current assets. With regard to question, as there is no information provided with regard to the stock of raw material or stock of works in progress, we will directly jump with the stock portion. For the purpose of the valuation of the stock, we would take the amount which we have been provided, which we have calculated in works in progress, that would be 68 lakh. Again, the question says that we have been provided that the stock would remain with us for 8 weeks. So we will multiply it by 8. As there is count given with respect to the weeks, we have to take the same aspect while calculating the thing. We have discussed that usually working capital information is given with regard to year. 1 year is equals to 12 months is equals to 52 weeks or is equals to 365 days. Whatever the unit is given in the question, we should follow that unit. But again, this particular question, with respect to this particular question, it is being seen that the question says that there are 50 working weeks, so we would multiply it, we would divide it by 50. 68 lakh multiplied by 8 divided by 50, we would get our answer as 10 lakh 88,000. Remember one thing, the information which is provided in the question would be taken for the purpose of the calculation. Hence here the information was given that average stock in hand with the company is for 8 weeks. We have taken it for 8 weeks. The information is again given about debtors also, so we would take debtors. Again the calculation would be made on the amount which we have calculated in working mode, that is 68 lakh. What is the average duration of collection from debtors? It is 10 weeks divided by 50, which is the portion given in the question that usually there are 50 weeks in an year for the purpose of calculation. So 68 lakh into 10 divided by 50, we would get our answer as 13 lakh 60 thousand. Next thing with related to the asset is given is that there is a cash requirement or company has a tendency to maintain cash at a level of rupees 50,000. So we have all these current assets given in the question, hence we can now make the total of our current assets. Total current assets, so 10,88,000 plus 13,60,000 plus 50,000, it would be 24,98,000. 24,98,000. Second thing is given, is to be taken with related to the aspect of current liabilities. Current liabilities, again with respect to current liabilities, we have been said that the supplier has allowed an average credit period of 4 weeks. So we have to take for the suppliers. Suppliers are usually the creditors of the company. So it would be 68 lakh multiplied by 4 divided by 50. 68 lakh, which is being cost of sales, multiplied by average time period given by each supplier is 4 weeks divided by number of weeks in a year for the company, 50. So our answer is 5,44,000. With regard to wages or overheads, no information has been provided, so we would not take that into consideration. It would be nil. We would just make the total 5,44,000. We would transfer it into the second column of amount. What we have get here, that is the B portion. Total current liabilities. Total current liabilities. Now we have to calculate working capital. What was the formula for working capital? Current assets minus current liability. Current assets minus current liabilities, that is A minus B. So 24,98,000 minus 5,44,000 would be 19,54,000. 19,54,000. This was the working capital. But again, the question says that for the part of contingency, we have to provide for 10% portion of our working capital. So we have to again add contingency provision. It would be 10% of this working capital, 19,54,000 into 10%, that would be 1,95,400. 1,95,400. So we would now get the final total, that is 21,49,400. This is our net working capital requirement. Net working capital requirement. So this was for the relation with the calculation of working capital management. We would be given normally with the amount of sales, we have to deduct profit from it. If it is given on cost, we use formula sales into percentage of profit divided by 100 plus profit, we would get our cost of sales. This cost of sales would be used at every point of time for the purpose of calculation. We all know what are our current assets. We would use that current assets for the purpose of the calculation of working capital. For example, in this case, we have been only provided with the stock. So we have taken 68 lakh into average time period 8 weeks divided by the period for 1 year was given 50 weeks, particularly in question. So we have taken 50, and similarly we have done for debtors. Cash was already given in the question. We have sum up all three and we get our total current assets, which we have transferred in the next column. Then was with our current liabilities, creditors, that is our suppliers. The information was given with regard to them. We have again calculated our creditors. At the same time, wages and overheads related information was not given, hence they were taken as nil, and we have transferred our total in the second column. For the purpose of calculation, we have discussed that what is formula for working capital. Working capital, current assets minus current liabilities, that is 24,98,000 minus 5,44,000, that is what is our 19,54,000 is working capital. At the same time, there was also been asked to maintain 10% provision for contingencies, which we have maintained, and we get our net working capital requirement of 21,49,400. This was with related to the solution. If suppose question doesn't say anything about the period, then we would take this as a standard. Otherwise, if something is mentioned specifically in the question, for example, for this question, it was specifically mentioned that consider 50 weeks in an year. So we have to consider that part. Otherwise, we would take the standard period. Okay. Till then, for the next video, stay tuned and try to solve as much as possible questions. Thank you.